Hello, my name is Scott Felber from the NX product marketing team. Welcome to the tips and tricks on Delete Curve. In this session today, we will go through a workflow to help you increase your productivity by being able to delete curves by yet maintaining your complete closed profile in your sketches. So let's get on with the first example. Let's get started and jump into the sketch. Let's say for instance here, we want to delete the two left lines in the curve here. When we go ahead and delete those, we now have an open profile. We can use traditional commands such as corner to go ahead and close up the gap between those two curves. But now, how do I go ahead and delete the notch over on the right hand side? Let's go ahead now and undo those deletes. And under the more on the edit toolbar, there's a command called delete curve. It uses selection 10 and other things, but we have the heal option turned on. You can see now as we delete the curves, when it deletes the two curves, we get a preview of the curve it will automatically create for us. This is great news, and now it went ahead, deleted the unneeded dimensions and constraints, and patched up our curves. We can now go ahead and do the same with the notch and get one line instead of two if we're using traditional methods of trim and extend. Now that we are done making our design change, we just go back to our model, finish up, and the model updates. But we notice that the edge blends fail. So we go ahead and take a look at them. We notice that the edges that they were originally blended from are gone because we took them out of our sketch. So it's just as easy now as just deleting those two blends to continue on with our design process. Let's now take a look at another use case. Here we have a gasket-like part, and what we want to do is we want to create a new gasket from this. So first thing we want to do is we want to take our outer shape and just create an offset to offset those curves a distance to accommodate our new design change. We're going to go ahead and create the dimension and constraints for those, but now we want to delete those inner lines to get back to where we were at. Again, now using the delete curve command that we saw before, with the built-in selection intent we have, we can say take the connected curves and we can take our inner profile, go ahead and in one step just delete it. As we continue on our design process, we can see in the upper corner we have this cauliflower-like area that we want to remove to streamline our new design. Again, using delete curve, we can use single curve selection in conjunction with multiple select rules to draw around the curves we really want to delete. Once we have all the curves selected with the lasso command, and any curves we may have missed, as we pick, we can now see the result we're going to get with the heal command. This is very nice, except for we have that little bit of notch on the bottom. We could draw an arc in there or whatever, or we could use the curve from the bottom as this is a symmetric part and mirror it over to the top side of our design. Once we do that, all we need to do now is just go ahead and trim back the existing curves to the new curve we just mirrored over to complete our design task. Again, this delete curve is a very powerful command. So let's recap what we saw today. We saw the ability by using the built-in delete curve command that has built-in selection intent and healing capabilities to help you increase your productivity within the sketcher. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed this tip.